In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today the Church celebrates the holiness of Saint Ezequiel Moreno, a bishop who belonged to the Order of Augustinian Recollects. He once was in Palawan and served there. Let us ask the prayer of Saint Ezequiel, that we too may always be ready to offer everything to the Lord. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who chose blessed Saint Ezequiel Moreno to preside as bishop over your holy people, we pray that by his merits you may bestow on us the grace of your loving kindness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, by a sudden blow, I am taking away from you the delight of your eyes. But do not mourn or weep or shed any tears. Groan in silence. Make no lament for the dead. Bind on your turban. Put your sandals on your feet. Do not cover your beard, and do not eat the customary bread. That evening, my wife died. And the next morning, I did as I had been commanded. Then the people asked me, will you not tell us what all these things that you are doing mean for us? I therefore spoke to the people that morning, saying to them, thus the word of the Lord came to me. Say to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, I will now desecrate my sanctuary, the stronghold of your pride, the delight of your eyes, the desire of your soul. The sons and daughters you left behind shall fall by the sword. Ezekiel shall be a sign for you. All that he did, you shall do when it happens. Thus you shall know that I am the Lord. you shall do as I have done, not covering your beards, nor eating the customary bread. Your turbans shall remain on your heads, your sandals on your feet. You shall not mourn or weep, but you shall rot away because of your sins and groan one to another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
You were unmindful of the rock that begot you. You forgot the God who gave you birth. When the Lord saw this, he was filled with loathing and anger toward his sons and daughters.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
I will hide my face from them, he said, and see what will then become of them. What a fickle race they are, sons with no loyalty in them.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
Since they have provoked me with their no God and angered me with their vain idols, I will provoke them with a no people. With a foolish nation, I will anger them.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth. Please stand.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
A young man approached Jesus and said, Teacher, what good must I do to gain eternal life? He answered him, Why do you ask me about the good? There is only one who is good. If you wish to enter into life, keep the commandments. He asked him, Which ones? And Jesus replied, You shall not kill, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, honor your father and your mother, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself. The young man said to him, All of this I have observed. What do I still lack? Jesus said to him, If you wish to be perfect, go, sell what you have and give it to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me. When the young man heard this statement, he went away sad, for he had many possessions. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon. Based on the Gospel, my dear sisters and brothers, there seems to be two levels of spirituality. The first level is what I may call as the minimum, the basic. The young man asked, What must I do to enter into eternal life. And Jesus said, keep the commandments. Sundin mo yung mga utos ng Diyos. Huwag kang papatay, huwag kang mangangalunya, huwag kang magnanakaw, huwag kang magsisinungaling, mahalin mo ang iyong ama't ina, igalang mo ang iyong mga magulang, at mahalin mo ang iyong kapwa. That is the basic, the minimum. It means that if we follow this thing, if we keep the commandments, there is an assurance that we will enter heaven. But it looks like there is also another higher level, because the young man was not satisfied. So Jesus said to him, if you wish to be perfect, So in other words, aside from the doing the basic, the minimum, if you want to go up further, no, like don't be satisfied with basic education, go to high school, finish it, and then if you are finished with high school, go to college, finish it, and if you want to go up higher, take graduate studies. The Lord said, be perfect. Do not just be satisfied with the minimum. Try or strive to be perfect. So, ano pong ibig sabihin nun? Sa marami sa atin, oo, ginagawa natin ang tinutupad natin ng mga utos ng Diyos, hindi tayo pumapatay, hindi tayo nagnanakaw, hindi tayo nakikiapid. Basic yon. Ginagalang natin ang ating mga magulang. Nagsisimba tayo kung araw ng Linggo, nagko-contribute sa simbahan. Basic yon. Pero wag lamang tayong masatisfy sa basic. Kaya nga yung iba, pumapasok na seminaryo o kaya nagmamadre, because they want to be, to give more than the basic. Yung iba, hinahati ang kanilang mga ari-arian, binibigay sa mga mahihirap. Hindi sila satisfied sa basic. At yun ang gusto ng Panginoon na gawin ng binata. You have so much with you. Go, sell what you have and give it to the poor. Share what you have. Do not just enjoy the blessings of the Lord. Share the blessings. And here, the promise is, you will not have treasures on earth, yes, because you have given them away. But Jesus assures him, you will have treasure in heaven. That is perfection. My dear brothers and sisters, today in the gospel, the Lord is striving, is inviting us not only to be satisfied with the minimum, rather we strive to be perfect. One last point. In the gospel, Jesus said, when the young man heard this statement, when he heard the challenge, no, he went away sad, for he had many possessions. Hindi niya kaya na sagutin ang hamon ni Jesus. Umalis siya. And the problem with the man is this. He did not really know who Jesus was. Because Jesus could have given him more than he was willing to give away. Sayang kung tumaya lang siya kay Jesus, siguradong jackpot. Eh hindi. Pinili niyang umalis. Kaya, talo. Amen.
Please stand.
Jesus Christ challenges us to exchange the material riches of this world for His eternal wisdom. Our prayers as His people can help us enter His kingdom. And so, to every petition, our response would be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may free men and women from the materialism and folly. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders may not sacrifice their principles for power, success, and ambition, but commit themselves to promote human dignity and values of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That parents and educators may challenge the young to live for things that really matter. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians who are rich in possessions and talents may learn to share what they are and have with those who have less. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our beloved dead may have the feel of the riches of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, grant us courage, joy, trust, and integrity. Make us wise with the wisdom of Jesus, who lives with you forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon this sacred altar, on the feast day of Blessed Ezekiel, that bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations may give honor to your name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us your signs of your love. And that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exultation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, including Ezequiel Moreno, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
As one family, we pray to our common Father in the words Jesus himself gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Renewed by the sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that following the example of Blessed Ezequiel Moreno, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.